Hi, I'm Laurel Oldach, a biochemistry reporter for Chemical and Engineering News. And when I'm not writing about biochemistry and the biotech and pharmaceutical industries for the magazine, I also perform with a community dance troupe. So one of my favorite annual news events is the Dance Your PhD contest. This year's winner is a chemist, Sulo Roukka of the University of Helsinki, who just recently earned his PhD this spring. He studied differences between individuals in chemical sensation, but after watching the video, some of us on the C&EN team were still a little unclear on exactly what he did scientifically. So let's take a look.
Feel the heat, feel the freeze. It's chemistry, oh please. Tiny sensors deep inside, set your taste buds on a ride.
So, mint and chili peppers are really famous foods in the chemical sensing world because compounds from those two plants happen to bind to ion channels that your body normally uses to sense heat and cold. In fact, capsaicin, which is the compound that makes spicy foods taste hot, was originally used to find that heat-sensing protein, TRPV1. The biochemist who led that research, David Julius, shared the Nobel Prize for his efforts in 2021. We'll keep going.
Capsaicin burning high, mental chills, oh my mind.
What? Guys, we don't drink the chemicals in lab. But in this specific case, it's okay because the PPE costumes are just artistic license. Roukka really did have volunteers sip different solutions of three compounds, capsaicin, menthol, and aluminum ammonium sulfate at different concentrations to test their sensitivity to the different flavors of those compounds. Dad jokes aside, ammonium sulfate is actually kind of an interesting compound because it's less of a one-to-one receptor-to-ligand interaction than with capsaicin and menthol, which both activate specific ion channels that also happen to sense hot and cold temperatures. We experience ammonium sulfate as kind of an astringent taste, sort of a makes-your-mouth-pucker kind of a feeling, but we don't really understand the chemistry of exactly why. Scientists think that TRP channels, the ones that sense menthol and capsaicin, might be involved, but they're not totally sure.
Every sip, every taste shapes the choices that we make. Spicy lovers bring the sauce, cool and crew, chillin' boss. From cocktails to chili fries, chemistry in every bite.
Here's the part where we get to his actual research. So, Sulo Roukka tested different people's sensitivity to the three compounds, put together a combined score of their overall sensitivity, and then looked at factors influencing why taste varies between people, like age and gender, found that some things don't make a big difference, like smoking, which was a surprise, and also looked at how your chemical sensitivity influences other choices about food, like whether you always salt your vegetable water before boiling your vegetables, or whether you like to put milk in your coffee or tea. He found that people who were more sensitive to capsaicin tended to be much more likely to always put milk in their coffee, which I thought was kind of interesting.
Flavors win, flavors lose, drinks and sauces mask or boost. Every tongue, it's so true. Hot and cold, fire and ice. Who's the king? Roll the dice. Hot, cold, clash and burn.
This part is just fun. I love the sequin costumes. I love all the costumes. I love the lab coats coming off so that we're suddenly not in the supply room of the lab. We're in a club in Helsinki somewhere. And, you know, for a room full of scientists dancing together, they did pretty good. I would hang out in that university break room. So when you put all that together, I think between the description of the science, the awesome use of props, the neat use of space, the track that they wrote themselves, and then the fun, not too technically demanding, but super high energy choreo, it's clear why they won the Dance Your PhD contest. So, thanks for watching. Hope to see you next year.